Ah, one of the best, the lively and colorful Riverwalk. Just part of what makes San Antonio such a great town. Welcome, everybody, to the day we've all been looking forward to. The start of a new NBA season on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Brent Berry. From the sideline, we'll have David Aldridge. We'll be hearing from him in just a moment. DA, it's all yours.
Well, guys, DeMar DeRozan is a prolific scorer, but he's also a dangerous driving kick weapon. He said, "I never pay attention to the defender guarding me. I look at the four guys behind him and how they react. A lot of times, I don't even look to score. I draw three or four guys and get my teammates open shots." Kevin?
Great vision, David. Thank you. A chance now to check out the Knicks' upcoming schedule. On Friday, they'll face off against DeAndre Jordan and the Brooklyn Nets. And then on Saturday, they'll be matching up against Gordon Hayward and the Boston Celtics. So a look at our starters for the Knicks. We've got Randall. Peyton is out there with Barrett. Then there's Mo Harkless. And it's Gibson in at the pivot, manning the middle. And for San Antonio, they've got Poeltl. White is out there with Murray. Then it's DeRozan. And it's Walker in at the three, the small forward. The starting gate, opening night in the NBA. Brent, what are you most looking forward to?
I just like to see who it is that, in terms of their competitive spirit right now, is coming out of training camp hungry. Let's see in the next couple weeks which team jumps out and which coaching staffs have done a great job preparing their team coming out of camp. Now, we know that teams can fall off, Kevin, that talent will catch up. Other veteran teams may get themselves back into a rhythm. But coming out of training camp, how much more together are teams, and teams that have made changes, what are they playing like?
What's their chemistry?
Exactly. Let's find out how they're going to play this year.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
And five straight triple-doubles last season for Elfrid Payton, showing his all-around impact.
Amazing with his size and athleticism at the point guard position that he has that kind of versatility. That's some lofty company. I mean, five straight triple-doubles, what an amazing run by EP.
He misses the free throw.
Well, no secret that the Knicks were planning for a massive free agency and a free agent signing this past summer. They cleared a lot of cap space and were hopeful that their draft choice would be that number one slot. It did not come to fruition.
And he sinks the second. And a lot of people, Brent, feel that without a doubt, the Knicks are still a destination for free agents.
Well, to vacation, it seems like, Kevin, because not a lot of the free agents are signing to play basketball in New York City. You know, they put a lot of faith in that idea that it's the number one market and the best place to live, and you can make a lot of money off the court. But over the past 10 years, have not seen much action out of New York City.
And here's White. He'll bring it up for the San Antonio Spurs. Murray with the bounce pass. Harkless with the steal. Nice D from DeRozan.
Early on, three misses to open the game. Their offense right now still trying to find its way.
Jumps up, and Harkless slams it in.
Hands of Randall starting that possession, Kevin.
Outside, White. An easy 2 points on the layup.
And despite the size disadvantage, attacking the heart of that defense.
Yeah, no stopping him on that play. Sometimes even the taller defenders are helpless to stop him.
And so here is New York following the bucket by the Spurs. Barrett, no good.
Still searching out their offensive game right now. 1 of 5 from the field to start this one.
Peyton against Murray. Outside, Walker. Goes up at the stripe. The rebound by Gibson.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
Here's Barrett. No good that time. Walker with some nice D. Here's Murray, and it's blocked. And the whistle stops gameplay. It's not a clean block shot, instead a shooting foul, and we'll see free throws coming up right here.
And making his return from the ACL tear, DeJounte Murray, long, athletic, and young. He still has a very bright future.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one misses. And Murray winning second team all-defense in 2018. And Greg, at that time, he was only 21.
And that's been his strong suit. If he can hit perimeter shots consistently, he can be a star.
And the second free throw, good. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Pirtle with the steal. DeRozan with it. Now guarded by Gibson. Knocked loose. And it goes out of bounds. That one off Gibson.
And while we have a moment, let's check the stats for DeRozan. He's coming off an excellent season. Last year averaged 21 points per, 6 assists and 6 rebounds. And you look at the numbers he's been putting up. Fantastic scoring production from him.
Yeah, hard to ask for anything more at this point. He's really stepped up, and he's really delivered.
Now, here's Walker. Pass to DeRozan.
Now, Gibson is going to get gritty on defense. Does a solid job right there of staying in front of his man. Nothing easy.
And a better box out saves them 2 points there.
It didn't seem like anybody was really aware there to go and collect that rebound in the possession.
Now here's Payton. Outside Gibson. Pass to Randall. And Randall throws it down.
Randall with a great effort there. Up and athletic and at the rim.
Now here's White. He's guarded closely. He kicks it to Pirtle. Fires from deep. Hands it from downtown.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Knicks trail by 3. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, and Randall throws it down.
Randall getting up there, explosive vertically on that play with great timing.
Now here's Murray. Outside, White. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. White's got 5.
When he's hitting that shot, this offense becomes scary, even more difficult to defend.
But no question, when he is connecting from those kind of spots on the floor, it is just a huge boost for what they can do offensively.
Here's Randall following the 3-pointer by San Antonio. The 3, Payton gets the bucket.
Yeah, the man was wide open there, and Julius Randall understood the timing to get him the ball to get that score.
Murray against Payton. Murray, no good.
Well, a lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup. Got to love the effort there. An undersized 4 who can really make things happen with that leaping ability.
Now here is Pirtle. Tries it again, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. 2 shots coming up. And there's the call. New York with the foul.
And Pirtle is so polished in the post. Defenders are always nervous when he has the ball down low.
It's his first trip to the line.
And not the guy you want to see at the line too often. Season numbers has him in the bottom tier of the league.
Shooting 2.
The free throw drops for Pirtle.
And Pirtle is a massive guy, someone that uses his height exceptionally well to get high-quality looks at the bucket.
Looking at who's out there now for the Spurs. Rudy Gay's checked in for Lonnie Walker. Bryn Forbes comes in for Derek White. And it's Mills in for DeJounte Murray. And a new group in for the Knicks. Mitchell Robinson's checked in for Gibson. Bobby Portis comes in for Julius Randle. Reggie Bullock, he's checked in for Maurice Harkless. And it's Ntilikina in for Peyton. Here's Ntilikina. Shot left block. And Poeltl sends it back.
Wonderful anticipation from Poeltl on that one, positioning himself perfectly to send that one back.
Back to Gay. Poeltl, the pass to Forbes. Just five on the clock. Mills can't hit.
Having a hand up in your face makes such a difference to a shooter.
Yeah, as good as you can do without getting a block there to defend.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
We'll see if they can finally hold on to a lead. It's been back and forth all night.
Well, you can tell they really want to increase this lead. They can't keep letting them take it from them.
Here's Gay following the score by New York. It's rebounded by Portis.
Yeah, my expectations were that he was not going to miss that one, Kevin. He handles that kind of defense, especially on the inside.
Out left of the wing. Here's Ntilikina, covered by Mills. But they'll get another chance. There's the pass to Barrett. Launches it. Up and in, it's good. First basket of the game for him. One for four shooting.
And well, like a lot of young players, Barrett's working hard to become proficient from range.
Offensive rebound. Robinson with the block. And it's out of bounds. The Spurs able to retain possession here. And the Spurs with some changes. Tyler Zeller comes in for Jakob Poeltl. And it's Bellinelli in for DeMar DeRozan. Kevin Knox is checked in for New York. Here's Forbes. Again, the miss by the Spurs. Here's New York. They've outscored him 10 points to 2 during this run. Knox takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely. And the Knicks lead by 6. San Antonio's gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
I think Mitchell Robinson is one of those guys. We saw it last year. He might get 4 or 5 blocks a game. So many players tempted to shoot outside shots because Mitchell would play off of them, and then quickly he would get to them and deflect the shot. So incredible quick twitch fibers and quick to the ball to make an impact defensively.
Let's take a look at last year's leading shot blockers. You don't want one of these guys in front of you when you're coming down the lane. You look at Robinson, second in the NBA, a great defender.
And shot blocking is the element of the game that I think he cares about the most. That's where he puts in that effort and energy.
Here's Mills. And that time, also a missed shot. And with Robinson, if he played a full 40 minutes every game, Brent, his block numbers would be outstanding.
Look at you, Kevin, digging into the per 36 minutes statistics.
Yeah,
I like it. He's a great rim protector. He has great activity down there. And if he can stay with the game plan, I think Coach Fizdale is going to find ways to give him more minutes in this season.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Here's Gay. Chalk up two there.
Impressive handle by Rudy Gay. Don't often see that out of the 6'8 slender forward.
1:52 left here in the opening quarter. Robinson passes to Knox. Gay with the defensive effort.
And the pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
And the guard, Bryn Forbes, won back-to-back state championships as a high schooler in the state of Michigan. A couple years at Cleveland State, then transferred back to the state of Michigan and played at Michigan State.
And after that time at Michigan State, he went undrafted, but Kevin really has developed into a steady rotation player in the NBA. And by the way, quite a knockdown shooter.
And the first one drops. Brent, when you look back on all the stars you played against during your career, who was the biggest intimidator?
Well, I think about intimidating players, and the first word that comes to mind is Anthony Mason. I know he wasn't a bona fide star player, but
right.
You know the role that he had for
yes,
the teams
I do.
That he played with, and Anthony Mason was a player you did not want to be playing against. During my era, most of the years that I had some successes and minutes on the floor, it was certainly Kevin Garnett. The way that KG approached every game, and you spent many seasons watching him very closely, from year one to year 18 or 19, KG came at you every game, every night, with the same kind of zest and excitement to compete.
Well put. The Knicks with the lead. Here's Ntilikina. Forbes with the rebound.
I'm not going to see that very often. The defense in the vicinity, but still, he's not one to blow layups.
56 seconds left to play here in the first, and finished off by Gay.
Rudy Gay up off the ground and dunking it down hard. Nice to see that.
Passes it to Portis. Pass to Knox. Clock at six, and it's a defensive 3-second violation. The Knicks shooting their third free throw shot of the game. Free throw good, Bullitt. And the sharpshooter, Reggie Bullock. Took some time for him, Greg, here in the NBA. But, you know, he's going to shoot it.
Bullock has always been a consistent threat from outside. And that is why this team loves him. It doesn't offer too much else, but he can open up some room inside with that ability to hit from deep.
And the Knicks making a change here. Ellington's checked in. Bellinelli gets the bucket.
Yeah, and Bellinelli, very creative, has that ability to get into the heart of the defense.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here's Knox. New York needs to get off a shot. Ntilikina can't hit. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. It's the Spurs up one. Let's take a quick break now, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. Yeah. And in 2018, DeMar DeRozan opened up about his battles with depression, hoping to have a positive impact on others.
A lot of people shame to talk about it. Even myself, for a long period of time, people wonder why I was such a quiet guy, and that was part of it, not wanting to speak out about it, not wanting other people know exactly what I was going through. But you get to a certain age where you feel like it's all about helping others. It's not about you just being a selfish person about the things you're going through, other people going through stuff as well.
Yep, you love the honesty and the bravery to step forward and tell his emotional story.
Yeah, he opened a dialogue, Kevin Love following his lead to talk about anxiety. Athletes, as public figures, can have a broader impact than just entertaining, and we see it over and over again.
And it's been a pretty even game here after one quarter of play. And looking at what we've seen from the Spurs so far, guys, what do you think?
Well, pounding the boards is one way to gain an advantage. They simply owned the glass in that first.
Well, if you get physical out there, you can control the glass, and that helps you to control the pace of the game.
Setting the floor for the Knicks. Knox out there with Reggie Bullock. Then it's Robinson. Then there's Wayne Ellington. And it's Neil Akina in at the one. First one falls for. Well, you knew it was going to take some time for Kevin Knox, but Greg, at the end of last season, he began to show flashes of what he could do.
You could almost see the game starting to slow down for him about halfway through the season. Consistency is something all rookies struggle with, but it hit Knox especially hard. Fortunately, that is something that passes with time.
Kevin Knox got a ton of experience in his rookie year playing for the New York Knicks. The ninth overall pick in 2018 out of Kentucky. Played nearly 30 minutes a game. That's a lot of minutes to try to understand your game at the pro level and then what you need to work on.
Now here's Ellington. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
Hills with it. Ellington defending and finished off by Kay.
Well, there's a couple things that Patty is working on to be a better player in this league, and finding the open man is one of them.
Pass to Ellington. Here's Neil Akina. Just over a minute gone here in the second quarter. Now, here's Bullock. He's covered closely. Some nice passing by New York here. Top of the key. It's good. And the Knicks lead by one. Eight lead changes now, and we're still just in the first half.
And I'm not sure I've seen a game with more lead changes this early.
Gay outside. Kicks it to Mills. Here is Forbes. Ellington defending. It's Gay with the drive. That one doesn't go. So New York will take it the other way. They'll be off to Brooklyn for a meeting with the Nets after this one. That'll be the second of this two-game road trip.
Neil Akina wanting to be assertive and the coaching staff encouraging that kind of play.
Now here's Mills. Shoots it. And the jumper is on the mark.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
And so it's New York with it after the basket by San Antonio and the basket by Knox. Spurs trail by three. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Kevin, before he became a head coach in Memphis and New York, David Fizdale spent eight seasons as an assistant under Eric Spoelstra in Miami. Now, Spo said he's a brilliant basketball mind that has exceptional gold standard level communication skills. One of the most talented coaches I've been around. So, Kevin, Fizdale is highly respected.
David, he sure is. Great reputation. Now getting his shot. Thank you so much. And the Knicks decide to take their first time out here. Ray, you suited up for six teams in your NBA career. What do you think about some of the front offices that you came across during that playing time?
I think when you find a front office, when you move from franchise to franchise, is what it is that they value most. And there were some franchises, quite frankly, Kevin, that I played for where they just wanted you to show up on time, get there, play the game, and leave. Those franchises end up having a lot of struggle to find some footing in the league. They also find trouble finding attraction from free agency because people understand the culture just isn't there. There are other teams that do so many other things well, Kevin. You feel so much more valued as a player throughout your course of your career. Those are the places that end up sticking with you. And I think the league is doing a great job from top to bottom, moving in that direction. Now, some are doing it better than others. That will always be the case. But the idea around finding more completeness for what it is you provide a player is a great thing for everybody.
So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Jakob Poeltl's checked in for Tyler Zeller. DeMar DeRozan comes in for Marco Bellinelli. Derek White's checked in for Bryn Forbes. And it's DeJounte Murray in for Patty Mills. And a new group in for the Knicks. Taj Gibson's checked in for Mitchell Robinson. Julius Randle comes in for Kevin Knox. Barrett checked in for Reggie Bullock. And it's Peyton in for Frank Ntilikina. Now here's Gay. 6 points for him. Over Peyton, another one falls for San Antonio.
That's too easy. A player of Rudy Gay's scoring prowess, he's salivating on shots like that.
Here's Randle, shooting foul. As the whistle blows, he'll shoot two free throws. It's going to be on Rudy Gay.
An expanding offensive game for Julius Randle, as the first few years he was driving in with his head down and not able to finish around taller players on the interior part of defenses. But last year, tremendous finisher, added some three-point shooting, and was much better from the mid-range. He becomes a bit of a matchup nightmare if he's got all three of those things working.
And he knocks down the first one. And Brent, the blend of strength, agility, and speed makes Randle a handful when he's going downhill.
He's dangerous around the rim, Kevin, and if he's got a live dribble where he's caught the ball around the elbow or the top of the key and could put the ball down on the deck and get up to speed, he becomes tough to guard. Be really interesting if the Knicks can explore him in some transition opportunities, getting out on the break where he might be able to rebound and push it out, a la a Draymond Green type of play.
Listen, there's no doubt he feels like they should have the lead, but that miss will keep it all tied up.
And here's Peyton. He'll bring it up for the New York Knicks. And there's the pass to Gibson. Shoots over Poeltl. Shot's good by Gibson. Gibson's got it all tied up now for the Knicks.
Working on the inside, Taj Gibson goes to it. Tremendous at imposing his will down there.
Murray, the pass to DeRozan. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Murray's got three assists now in this one.
Pretty much not a player in the league's going to pass up a shot like that, so much for the defense.
Now here's Peyton. He dishes it to Gibson. Releases. Here's Randle. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Randall's got 9 points.
So active and understanding more and more with his experience where to be to get offensive rebounds is Julius Randle.
Shot's good by Walker.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
Peyton looking around. Here's the teardrop. And here's the fast break. Walker leading the way. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. Pass to Barrett. The shot missing. Walker with some nice D. Here's Murray. Good. Nice job down low. Now it's a 6-point Spurs lead. Knicks have gotten exactly half their shots to go down here in the second, 5 of 10. Murray against Peyton. Pass to Barrett. Now Gibson, 5 on the clock. And Poeltl pulls it down. Poeltl's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one.
You know, altered shots don't show up on the official stat sheet, but as we saw there, he does a great job of doing that as well as collecting the rebound.
Great positioning on the putback.
Gibson using his body on the boards. He's great at using his timing to leap up and collect a second chance.
Here's Murray. The rebound by Gibson. Gibson's got four rebounds now tonight. Pass to Barrett over Walker. And Barrett with the basket on the assist by Mo Harkless. Harkless has got three assists in the game. Payton against Murray. The dish to Pirtle. White left side. Murray outside. Shoots from the elbow. Here's Pirtle. Lays it up off the glass. Pirtle's got seven.
And Pirtle has a stick with it mentality on the offensive glass, just throwing himself against the board.
Payton attacking. Rebound by Murray.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
And Alfred Payton with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And New York making a change here. Portis has checked in. Here's DeRozan. No good on the triple. Knicks trail by four. It's stolen by DeRozan. Murray outside. The pass to Pirtle. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. Murray's got four assists now tonight.
There's no stopping Pirtle when he has the ball in that spot, just abusing the defense down in the paint.
Now here's Harkless. Passes it to Randle. Shoots over DeRozan. That is good, and the Spurs lead is cut down now to just four in the basket from Randle.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
White looking around. Here's DeRozan. And that one drops. DeRozan's got the lead up to six now for the Spurs.
Yeah, that first quarter was a bit shaky. Good to see a player who doesn't let a slow start get to him.
Harkless finds Payton. To the inside. Shot clock at six. New York moving it around. Launches a three. And no good. Murray with the defensive effort.
And hard work on the glass. Once again, guys, they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard. Traditionally, that's how you want to finish the break, right at the rim.
Yeah, anything other than a layup in that situation, probably disappointing. Had numbers, took advantage.
Now here's Harkless. He kicks it to Barrett. Pass to Randle. Shoots over DeRozan. Randle no good.
Well, with his touch from mid-range, Kevin, that's almost always good. That won't shake his confidence.
Outside DeRozan. Good, and the assist goes to Murray. And now it's an 11-point Spurs lead.
Well, he made some kind of adjustment to his game after a poor first half. He's been impressive shooting the ball during the second.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. And here is Payton. Here's Randle. Ball's knocked loose. Here's White. And he banks in the layup. White's got 4 points now in the quarter. And so it's San Antonio. 13 points up at the end of the period. Their defense has been terrific in this game. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks a lot. Rudy, it looked like you guys found your old identity in the first half tonight.
Yeah, that's the way we played last season. Our defense was our staple, and that's all we have to do. We have to go out here and play defense every night, and this is a good start for us.
Let's see if you can stay true to yourself in the second half. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, Dave, for the great interview. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball right after this.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show. Boy, a lot of energy in this arena tonight. The hometown fans getting after it. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaquille O'Neal's here. So is Kenny the Jet Smith. A pretty close game for the Spurs throughout the first quarter. They did jump out to a lead in the opening period, but 4 points was the biggest it got. The second quarter was where they really opened things up. They were by far the stronger team, both defensively and when they had the ball. Their 13-point halftime lead, no accident. And Shaq, what are your thoughts on how San Antonio played?
You got to like their offense efficiency. They were patient, took good shots. That was reflected in their high field goal percentage. They just need to keep playing smart in the second half and close this thing out. Don't get cute now.
And Kenny, your take on New York?
Their inaccuracy from behind the arc was brutal. Shot selection, I didn't see any. The perimeter offense they're running, you could scrap that. They need to get back to the basics. Pound it inside, more pick and roll. Try to pick up some easy buckets in transition.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
goodbye.
Kenny. Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. We're seeing a tremendous game from Julius Randle.
Yeah, and through the first two quarters, he has been the offense for this team.
Yeah, he's shouldering the load right now and looking really comfortable while he's doing it.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. On the court right now for the Spurs, we've got Murray, DeRozan out there with Pirtle, then it's White, and it's Walker in at the three slot.
Good show of confidence. Peyton looking good, trying his luck from the interior that time.
Murray against Peyton. Here's the floater. Murray, good. Murray's got the lead up to 13 now for the Spurs.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Here's Peyton trying to get open as Gibson. Peyton, that's good. Peyton's got 8 points.
I like to see this on a nightly basis happen a few more times. He knows he's got to get better at the mid-range jump shot.
Now here's DeRozan, defended by Harkless. They get it again, Pirtle. Great D that time from Gibson.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
And Randle throws it down.
And you see the passing instincts Barrett has. Great at recognition out on the floor.
Big man who was forgotten about during free agency, Randle could be an impact player for the Knicks.
Knicks missed out on the marquee names they were after, but Randle should give them great production for quite some time. Not a huge name, but a young talent that can help this team.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, we all know that circumstances and time changes everything. In Dallas, Dennis Smith Jr. thought he was going to be the cornerstone. But with the arrival of Luka Doncic, everything changed. The promising point guard was traded to the Knicks. And Smith said it was important. It's a big opportunity, and I've just got to make the most of it. Kevin, we know one thing. In New York, the ball is back in Smith's hands.
And D.A., that's when he is at his best. Thank you. Here's Harkless following the bucket by the Spurs. And Barrett gets it to go.
Yeah, they've only missed one out of their first 5 shots here in the second half, guys. Their offense really moving well, ball snapping, and the shooting looks to be in great rhythm.
Now here's White. He's got 9. Pass to DeRozan. Kicks it to Walker. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Pirtle, the pass to DeRozan. Second chance shot. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's on R.J. Barrett.
And the way Pirtle uses his 7-foot frame, so skilled in how he earns calls on his way up with the shot.
He's gone 2 for 2 at the line so far. That free throw, no good. A different look now for San Antonio. Rudy Gay's checked in for Walker. Bellinelli comes in for Derek White. And it's Mills in for Murray. Good on the second free throw. Here's Ntilikina. And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Here's Robinson, the 15-footer, good. Robinson's got his first bucket in this one.
You can't just stop when there's a pick set up. Gotta fight over it as a defender.
That's one that the coaches will watch tomorrow with that player. You hate to see him give up in that situation.
Now here's Mills. Just 5 to shoot. Fires the 3. Good on the triple. Mills has got 5 points so far.
For all the strides he's made in other parts of his game, Mills remains at his heart a dead-eye 3-point shooter.
The pass to Knox. Ellington, the pass to Knox. Tipped away. Over DeRozan. Rebounded by the Spurs. 13 points was their biggest lead in the game.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Knicks trail by 10. Here's Knox. And Pirtle sends it back. Passes it to Mills. Pirtle kicks to Gay. Up top to DeRozan. Sinks that one from the post. 12 points for him.
Another good play. This is how they built the lead, calling on the right guys at the right time.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but its importance to a team showing up here, running plays that turn into scores.
Pass to Bullock. This one for 3. New York, no good that time either. San Antonio leading by 12. Gay with no one around. And again, it's San Antonio with a 3.
Now this is Rudy Gay's game, outstanding at seizing the initiative and then looking to shoot once he catches the ball.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
Now here's Bullock. He's covered by Gay. Pass to Ntilikina to halt the run. Oh, good on that one. And the Spurs going the other way now. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. They'll find themselves in the middle of this string of 3 straight at home. Mills passes to Pirtle. Now here's DeRozan. D right on him. And that one, good.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Looking at who's out there now for the Spurs. Tyler Zeller comes in for Jakob Poeltl. And it's Bryn Forbes in for Bellinelli. And a switcher also for New York. Portis, he's checked in for Ntilikina.
It's common to see wing players improve their perimeter shooting in the league, but DeMar DeRozan's most striking growth has been his ball handling and playmaking. He's been dynamic with the ball in his hands.
New York calls timeout. And Greg, DeRozan watching a ton of films of guys like Andre Miller and Sam Cassell operating in the pick and roll.
Not only that, Kevin, to strengthen his left hand, he'd use it for daily activities like writing, leaving no stone unturned to become an expert initiator. looking here at some numbers for Robinson. Last season's performance for him, averaged 7 points per game, almost 2.5 blocks and 6 rebounds. And his defensive presence inside, not to be overlooked. He builds a wall around the basket.
Yeah, over this whole last stretch of games, he's been shutting down the lane with total authority. Impressive stuff.
And so it's New York with it. They trail by 18. Banked in off the glass. Robinson's got his second bucket of the night.
He's been accurate tonight. I think the best way for them to succeed is to get him more shots. Sounds simple, but it comes down to execution.
Now here's Mills. He's got 5. From 13, Robinson pulls it in. Robinson's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Knox the pass to Ellington. And he's going up for the alley-oop. And it goes out of bounds. That one is off Zeller. Two on the clock. Puts it up. Off the inbound. In deep. Robinson drops it in. Robinson's got 6.
Well, the pick didn't exactly neutralize the defender, but good concentration on the finish to still get the basket.
Now, here's DeRozan. He's got 15. That one off the back iron and out.
This is a rough stretch right here for him offensively. Seems to be rushing shots.
The pass to Bullock. Knocks it loose. In transition, here come the Spurs. 3 from Gay. He scores a 6th bucket from the floor with that one. He's shot the ball 11 times.
Wow, when Rudy Gay's connecting there, that's going to help out a lot. It really opens up the rest of the court.
Now here's Ellington, covered by Mills. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. And the former Razorback, Bobby Portis, took a few years to find his spot in the NBA. But now, he does produce.
And great big man to bring in off the bench. Good size and quickness combination, and will always give you scoring with that second unit.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good. And good on the second, so he makes them both. And obviously some good players have taken less money for a chance at a winning championship situation. That's made some rich teams even better.
Well, you have to appreciate a player in that regard, thinking that the financial gains that he could have somewhere else and playing for a team that's not capable of doing what it is that you're trying to do, and that's win a championship, that they've decided, look, it's not about that for me. What it is about the experience of being around a team that elevates itself to being the best team in the league. And if you're fortunate enough at the highest level, Kevin, as a basketball player, to be around a championship, that experience sticks with you for a lifetime. So you do appreciate guys looking for those opportunities to be around a champion.
It's good from long range. Bullock's got 6.
He can be a forgotten man in their offense sometimes, but the D still has to keep an eye on him.
Mills looking it over. From 13, here's Zeller, and foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. First trip to the line for him here.
A 78% foul shooter a season ago. Pretty steady when he's at the line.
And the first one at the line is good. DeJounte Murray, he's checked in for Patty Mills. The Knicks also changing it up. Julius Randle's checked in for Robinson. Barrett comes in for Kevin Knox. And it's Elfrid Payton in for Wayne Ellington. And so Zeller nails both of them. And so Payton will bring it up for New York. 1:21 left here in the third quarter. 14 feet away, and it's Rudy Gay with the rebound. Gay's got his seventh rebound here tonight.
Maybe there are ways to contribute that don't involve shooting the basketball. That's the best way that maybe he can help them out trying to win this game.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another, Greg.
Now, here's Portis. Basket counts.
And you're not going to pass up that kind of look.
Spurs leading by 16. Now DeRozan. 17 points in the game. Murray kicks to Gay. Oh, good with a triple. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Payton passes to Portis. Payton's shot is off.
And the effort never stops with him. No easy shots when he's on the floor.
Well, it's about the defensive end, and that's what guys feed off. He gives the effort down there at all times.
Here's Barrett. Off on that one. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Spurs lead by 16. And coming up as soon as we return from break, the fourth quarter gets underway. And how about a look now at our assist of the game, brought to you by State Farm.
Yeah, and I like the fact we get to see this pass one more time. A magnificent feed, and you love to see your off guard taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
Yeah, sometimes that's what can separate some of the best players, not just creating for yourself, but creating for others as well.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. Knicks trail by 16, setting the floor for the Knicks. Randle and Portis patrol the middle. Barrett is out there with Payton, and it's Bullock in at the small forward.
You risk getting torched when somebody's open. Payton's skilled enough to find the open man.
Here's Murray after the made shot from Bobby Portis. Passes to Forbes. Outside, Walker. Pass to DeRozan. 5 to shoot. The Knicks pull it in. Randle's got his 4th rebound in this one. Here's Barrett. A rebound by the Spurs. Walker with a clean look. He clangs that one off the back iron and down it falls. 1 minute now into this 4th quarter. Pass to Barrett. Fades back, and the shot goes in.
An effective mid-range scorer, Barrett excels at finding openings in the defense and capitalizing.
Murray against Payton. Outside, Walker. Randle against Gay. Over Randle, takes the 12-footer and hits. 16 points for Rudy Gay.
Well, he's dialed in right now in the in-between game. I'd love to see Rudy Gay capitalize there.
Now the pass to Randle. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Murray, the pass to Walker. He kicks it to Forbes. Passes it to Gay. It's stolen by Randall. Here's Barrett. Lays it up and banks it in.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
Spurs leading by 12. Murray outside. Pass to Forbes. Walker surveying the floor. Pass to Gay. Over Randall. And there's Gay. That's good on the assist by Walker. And that's now 18 points for Rudy Gay. Knicks trail by 14. And the pass to Payton. Randall left side. Basket number 8 is all good. He's attempted 12 shots.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Murray against Payton. Gay outside. Here is Forbes. Outside, Walker. Beyond the arc. Gay misses. For New York, they've gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. Portis finds Payton. Pass to Barrett. From the arc, trying to get open is Randall. Barrett, no good. And here's Gay. He'll bring it up for San Antonio. They led by as many as 18 points. From past the arc, another miss by Gay. Knicks trail by 12. Randall passes to Portis. Payton outside. Pass to Portis. Barrett with the ball. He's covered by Murray. Baseline Jay on the way. San Antonio with the rebound. Gay's got 9 rebounds now tonight. Murray kicks to Forbes. Pass to Gay. And the layup falls. Gay's got 12 points in just the second half.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. It's been quite a game for Rudy Gay.
And the defense has not provided any threat to stop him out there, so it should come to no surprise that he continues to attack the basket.
The Spurs with some changes. Jakob Poeltl's checked in for DeRozan. And it's wide in for Bryn Forbes. Taj Gibson's checked in for New York. Harkless comes in for Reggie Bullock. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, I was able to listen in on what Coach Fizdale was going over with his team. He told them, you can do a lot of great things out there and still lose if you don't take care of the boards. I want to see more effort. Gang rebounding. Everyone involved. That was his only focus. Kevin?
Thank you, David. Now here's Gay. After the miss from Elfrid Payton, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. And the Spurs lead by 16.
Love seeing Poeltl attack the glass, especially when he goes for the putback jam.
Here's Randall. Trying to get open is Gibson. Randall, no good.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
Now here's Randall. There's the pass to Barrett. Passes it to Gibson. pass to Payton. Lets it go from deep. And Poeltl pulls it down.
Well, if he wants to make the defense work, he's got to start knocking down the threes. Only one so far in this game for him, and none since halftime.
Now, here's Walker. Over Barrett. Walker's shot is off.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
Here's Randle, and Randle throws it down.
Yeah, he just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam. Gay outside. Right side to Walker. And Harkless pulls it down. Harkless has got 5 rebounds tonight. Kicks it to Payton. Looking for Gibson. He gets it there. And Poeltl sends it back. Walker in the corner. Over Payton. He gets that one to drop. He's now 5 of 12.
To leave a guy like that wide open from range, big mix-up.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And he drops in the layup off the glass.
That's just smart right there from Alfred. Terrific at taking the screen and then use up whatever available space you have.
San Antonio calls timeout.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
Moment for our Jordan player of the game, Jakob Poeltl.
And guys, it's been a rugged brand of defense he's played. I don't know why they keep taking the ball at him. It seems like every time they have, he's come up with the rejection. And with every block, he's only gotten more and more fired up.
DeMar DeRozan, he's checked in for the Spurs.
That's the guy they're going to keep going to, as they should. The lead's only going up if they keep feeding him.
Payton passes to Randle. San Antonio with the rebound. Poeltl's got his 16th rebound on the night. Now here's Murray. Defended by Harkless. Pass to White. Outside, Walker. The Spurs need to get a shot off here. Over Randle, and he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. And that's now 21 points for DeMar DeRozan. Payton against Murray. Harkless dishes to Payton. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Payton's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Good slice and dice from Payton there in the lane, finding room.
The pass to White. Murray outside. And it's DeRozan missing. And so it's Randle bringing it up now for the New York Knicks. Here's Payton. And it's White with the rebound. Spurs leading by 16.
And this is what they wanted. I mean, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. It can definitely be considered a statement win for the Spurs.
Their shot blocking turned out to give them a big advantage in this game.
Yeah, excellent defense around the rim there, Kevin. They were disciplined and focused.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
And so they'll take the first game of the season series, a team they'll only see twice. They're certainly happy to start it off with a win.
And a great team effort tonight, helped in large part with contributions and the nice night it ended up being for Jakob Poeltl.
Well, the tone was set by him defensively tonight, recorded a number of blocks, and that was a big difference maker, intimidating the other team.
Impressive job by the players, coaches, and don't discount the impact of these fans.
Awesome to see their output tonight, trying to urge their team on, and that can always help. That home advantage of home fans getting you going, fully on display here.
So New York ends up going with the new group. And here are the Knicks. 19-point game. Ellington with it. Passes it to Robinson. New York moving it around. Pass to Smith. Down to 5 on the shot clock. It's tipped. Now here's DeRozan. Ellington defending. Here's DeRozan. And so it's San Antonio, easily taking this one. It was a tale of two teams tonight, one that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
DeMar, big effort tonight. What is the state of mind of this club right now?
We're focusing in on the defensive end. We know if we get stops, we can definitely score whenever we want.
And you got it done tonight, DeMar. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that about does it for the first game of the new NBA season. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.